Hey, what's going on, everyone? My name is Prestige. Thank you so much for joining me on the channel. Today, we got an exclusive look at the brand new multiplayer map Rise. It's coming in the Black Ops 3 Awakening DLC on February 2nd for the PS4, and then a little bit later down the line for Xbox One and PC. But Rise is actually my second favorite map. My favorite map is Splash, which we'll get to see tomorrow, but Rise is right there next to it. This is one of those maps where you're going to have a really fun time navigating, not only just trying to take different paths, but also playing objective game modes like Domination and even Uplink. Now, the one major reason I like this map is because there's a huge portion of it that actually takes place underwater. The underwater combat for this map is absolutely extravagant. You're able to hide undercover under the water, you're able to actually get into some pretty extreme firefights under the water, and this is a perfect place to achieve the Dr. Lung calling card. That's a Dark Ops challenge that requires you to kill an enemy while you're both drowning. And that in itself is pretty difficult because there's only a select few maps that really allow you to do that successfully, Hunted being one of those maps. But now you'll be able to do it on Rise, and that's great because I still haven't unlocked the calling card either. But objective game modes, for example, Domination, the B, A, and C flags are found in these locations right here, as you can see on the mini map. It's really not that bad. I like where the B flag is because there's a lot of ways to enter that area, so it's really, really crazy when the time comes to capture that objective. But I really wish what they would have done is place this B flag over in the area where the water is. I think that there would have been a lot more water-based combat. I think it would have been a little bit more interesting to see the fights take place there. And if they really wanted to take it that extra mile, put it under the water. That would be cool. That would just be absolutely amazing to see it under the water, and it would make for a lot of really interesting engagements. And I'm sure they're going to be something like that in the future, just not yet. Now, I noticed that yesterday you guys were asking if Gauntlet was a medium, small, big map, and honestly, I considered it a bigger map. But this map right here, I consider a medium-sized map. You can easily traverse to certain areas. There's a lot of different and unique wall-running options. There's a lot of really weird corridors that you're able to traverse through. And honestly, I found it better to use either a submachine gun, an assault rifle, or a sniper on this map. There are plenty of long sight lines, and you're able to do very well with submachine guns, especially in objective-based modes. Just being able to come around a corridor super quickly and take out somebody with your razorback is a very good feeling, especially when it comes to capturing an objective. Being able to clear out one specific area, throw down a smoke grenade, and capture the B objective is very satisfying, especially where it's located. You almost have like this ring of death, right? Where everybody kind of converges onto the B objective. You have a couple different windows, a couple different corridors, and then you have like your main spawn points where you can get to, and there's really not that much cover around it. But that's what makes this objective really interesting, and honestly, it reminds me of the Black Ops 2 DLC map Encore. If you guys remember, I'll put a picture up on the screen right now. But that B flag location was right in the open. There were so many ways to get to it, and that's exactly what this reminds me of right here. So it's going to be very interesting, and it's going to be a great way for those of you to earn kills as well as get a lot of objective-based kills and earn a bunch of awesome score streaks. But overall, I think the reason why I like this map so much is because it really does heavily remind me of Call of Duty Black Ops 2. Just being able to navigate in certain areas, using your new movement abilities like wall running and going underwater, there's so many different ways to play this map that work for you that you're gonna have a blast regardless of what game mode you're playing. Regular kill-based modes like TDM, Kill Confirm, stuff like that, you're gonna have a lot of fun, but playing something like Domination, Uplink, or even Capture the Flag, you're gonna have an absolute blast just trying to use different navigation techniques to get from one area to the next. So I'd really love to know what you guys think down below in the comments section. If you enjoyed this video today, don't forget to click that like button down below, and don't forget to subscribe for more awesome videos each and every day. We're gonna be covering Splash tomorrow, and I hope you guys can join me there. Until next time, everybody, I am out. Peace. Hey, thank you so much for joining me at the end of the video. If you missed our preview of Gauntlet yesterday, make sure to click the annotation on the screen right now. And if you want to subscribe over on my second channel, don't forget to do that. There's always a link down below in the description. Thank you guys so much for watching my early gameplay. And until tomorrow, I'll see ya.